Texas A&M defensive tackle Justin Madubuike, one of the more interesting physical specimens in this defensive tackle class. Let's get into the pros and cons. The pros right off the rip, 40 plus pressures each of the past two seasons. He's already shown that productivity as a pass rusher, but at the same time, he's actually graded out better in run defense over the course of his career at Texas A&M, with run defense grades of 90.2 and 87.7 the past 2 years. He has a pretty ridiculous get off and has some very high level pass rushing reps on his tape this past season at Texas A&M, especially in that Ole Miss game where he really took over in that one as a pass rusher. So the physical tools are all there, and we've already seen them in action to some degree. But let's get to the cons. And the first one is he's a little bit undersized, only 293 pounds. You see him get moved off the ball, moved one-on-one, and struggle to separate from blocks once he's engaged. He may get engulfed in the run game at the next level, has to be kind of more of a gap shooter. One-gapping offenses are going to covet Madubuike, not necessarily guys who ask you to sit on blocks and then make plays from there. The other kind of concern is his production really stagnated, looking from 2018 to 2019. His pass rushing grade actually went down, and his run defense grade went down over from, like I said, from 2018 to 2019. You want to see that going up over the course of a guy's career. You want to see him learning more moves, and we have not necessarily seen that for him in his time at Texas A&M. So let's get to the player comp. For me, it's someone like Nick Fairley, who really dominated just off his pure athleticism. You know, coming out of college, Nick Fairley at Auburn came out with a 4.84 40-yard dash, Madubuike 4.83. Both have that similarly quick first step that, you know, gets them in a favorable spot. But you need more than that at the NFL level. I think we saw that with Fairley. Struggled because he didn't have a power sort of move in his game. Was a one-trick pony in that regard. Madubuike's going to have to add some play strength. Going to have to add some girth to add that power aspect to his game to be a complete all-around pass rusher at the next level. So the bottom line for Justin Madubuike is he has the physical tools, but he needs more moves, needs to keep getting bigger so he can be an every-down impact player in the NFL. Covet him in one gap schemes. You're a sort of two gapping, a 3-4 type of defense. This probably isn't your guy.
You want to get rid of me and get back to more great PFF YouTube content? All you have to do is push that button right there and subscribe. Thanks for watching.